Oh my gosh, guys, check out this new model I just designed, Spiked Knuckle Rings. Isn't that awesome? Each one of these is folded from a single square sheet of paper, no cutting, no taping, no gluing, and each one is adjustable, so it fits perfectly on your knuckles. I think this is so cool. Want to learn how to fold them? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this particular spiked knuckle ring, I used a 3-inch square of kami, which I painted on one side using this gold acrylic paint. But you can color it however you want, either with paint, marker, crayon, or even pencil, or you don't even need to color it at all. The good news is that this is a fairly easy model to fold. The bad news, there isn't any. Let's get cracking. But first I want to show you how to make 4 3-inch squares from a single 6-inch square of kami. So let's turn over and fold in half. Try to make the fold as exact as possible and crease it super sharp. And unfold and turn over and make a little tear at the top, right at the crease, and place it down so that we have a ridge right like this. And now holding like this, just separate your hands and the tear should go all the way down like that. And now we can fold this paper in half. And unfold and turn over and make a little tear at the top and tear all the way to the bottom. And you can do this with that sheet also. And now, like I said, you can color it however you want. Or you could paint it with gold acrylic paint like I did. And if you get a little bit on the white side, no worries, because you're not going to see this side. Okay, let's begin white side up, and let's fold diagonally in half. But don't actually fold it all the way in half. Let's leave about a millimeter. So it's about like that. And now let's turn over top to bottom and rotate, and let's fold in half in this direction. And unfold and rotate. And now let's fold this corner to this point. So it's like that. And now let's unfold these two corners. It's still a little bit wet, this gold acrylic paint. Okay, and let's rotate. And let's fold this bottom edge to the crease. And rotate. And now let's fold in half, right on the crease. And now we're going to fold this flap up, and the fold is going to go between this point and this point where this edge and this edge come together. So it's like that. I'm going to unfold so that you can see the crease. Okay, and refold it. And now let's turn over and let's fold this flap up so that it meets this flap. Okay, now we're going to partially unfold these two flaps. So just separate them like this, just partially. And now let's put your finger into this pocket. Oh my gosh, this paint is stuck. Okay, there we go. And now let's flatten it back down like this. Okay. And now let's fold this flap over. It's just like turning the page of a book, right on the crease. And let's turn over and let's fold this flap over. Okay, now we're going to separate these two flaps and this pocket can get folded back down. And let's turn over top to bottom. And now we're going to rabbit ear these two flaps together as if they're one flap. So let's fold this edge to this edge. And we don't need to fold the whole thing. Let's just fold from this point to the crease right there. And unfold. And let's fold this edge to this edge. And fold from here to the crease. And unfold. And now we're going to pinch this corner. So just pinch the edges together and make all three folds at the same time. And we have a rabbit ear. All right, now let's turn over. And now let's fold this corner to this point. And rotate. And let's fold this corner to the same point. And unfold. And now let's open that pocket again. And let's flatten like it was and open it. And now we're going to stick one flap inside the other. So it's like this. Now it looks like this flap ended up a little wider. So I'm going to try to stick this one inside and see if I have more luck. It goes further in. Yes, it does. Good. And now let's flatten it down like this. So this is what it should look like. And now you can put it on your finger. And if you find that it's too big, then what you can do is flatten it again and open this flap up. And now let's fold this edge up just a little bit. Well, however much you want to shorten it. If you want to shorten it a lot, then you fold it up a lot. But mine doesn't really need to be shortened at all. But I'm going to just fold it up like this. And now close the flap back like that. And now you can stick it back on your finger. And you see it's a lot more snug. And the last step is to sculpt it so that this point comes to a cone. This is optional. I mean, if you like it like this, then you're all set. But if you want to shape it, then what we want to do is try to push this in. And we want this to be a curve. So as you push this in, you can kind of pull these edges apart so that we have a nice curve like that. And this is what it should look like inside there. And you can just kind of curve this to taste. And if you want, you can put another fold in, a curved fold that goes from this point, curve, 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 to this corner. And we're just doing this on these two layers here. So it originates right here, and it curves, curves, curves to the corner. So it's like that. And let's do that on the other side. So it starts right about here, and it curves to the corner. Like that. And now just sculpt it to taste, try to make it as conical as possible and as aesthetic, however you like it, just shape it to taste. And now it looks pretty awesome. Check that out. The Spiked Knuckle Ring. And that's it. And now you just need to make one for each of the other fingers. And there it is. And now you are stoked with your stylin' spiked knuckles. Your friends are gonna be so jealous when they see you with your spiked knuckles. They're probably gonna ask you to fold some for them. And you can, that's a nice thing to do. Or you can just give them the link to this tutorial. And there you have it. All right, hope you guys were able to fold this, and I hope you love this model like I do, and I hope you have fun showing it to your friends. Bye-bye.